So what?
It's been 11 years since the chemical bombings almost killed everyone in the city. Swear to God, it's the first thing I care about every morning. Yeah!
Thank you.
I used to watch so many movies in the old days.
I guess we're playing near the Transformers again.
Getting ourselves into trouble.
Who let them in?
A choice.
I'd like to know that myself.
Sometimes I wake up at night and forget the fall even happened. That's about the only time I smile. And then I see the goddamn UV lights.
Not a few little things. I'll show you later. I remember cleaning out the furniture store last year. I did some big things following you. Hey, not fun.
Thank you. What? Oh! Sinner.
I keep telling everyone we should be getting ready for winter. Thank you.
For a miracle. We can take advantage of that. Anders had a plan.
What plan?
Lots of folk went missing after the war. I mean, look around. You can see memorials in every other street corner. Families needed to know what happened. And where there's a need, there's a business opportunity.
That's sick. Have you no decency?
Decency's dead, mate. It's eight or be eaten.
Widow of crutches. Anders, oozing charm, saying we'd fought with their dead husbands during the war. PK promised to tell them what happened to their husbands. It worked every time. They'd give us food, water, medicine, crystals, anything they had. They wanted closure. We gave it to them. The details changed, but we stuck to the same basic story. It always ended with an epic fight and some heroic act by the husband. In no time, we were richer than kings. At least, we thought we were rich. And then we hit the biggest score of all. Melinda was like every day living near Meatpacking Square. We did our usual thing. But before we leave, she says, my husband, he was the PK treasurer. The night he died, he told me they had a war chest, medicine, crystals, mostly. He'd want you to have it.
You got no shame. Let him finish. I bet they were skinning for themselves.
We give each other the look. It's in Houndfield, she says, but it's not safe during the day. The next night, we take Melinda to our safe house to gear up. She leads us to this dark zone near the chemical zone. It's in the basement, she whispers, shivering with fright. We tell her to stay behind, because, you know, if there's a fight, she'd just get in our way.
You left her on her own?
Yeah. Then we went looking for a way in. And eventually, we found it.
And?
There was no loot. Instead, there was a demolisher in that basement. We barely got out alive. No stash. Medicine, crystals, food, shies, nothing personal, just business.
The biter was bitten. Only in this case, it was a demolisher.
Turns out she'd been tracking us for some nice split up after that. I bet he's still out there hustling. I enlisted with the PKs. But hearing war stories at night, people who actually died fighting for what they believed in, it made me feel guilty every time. I blasted 2 months. Now I'm back where I started before the fall. A nobody. Telling stories.